Hello everyone. So today's session we will discuss about intermediate code generation. So in the analysis synthesis model of compiler, the front end analyzes a source program and creates an intermediate representation from which the back end generates target code. So simply we describe here that in compiler analysis synthesis model, the front end analyzes a source language and convert that source language into intermediate representation, and that intermediate representation takes as input for the backend and generates target code by using that the intermediate representation. So the details of the source language is restricted to the only frontend side, and the details of the target language is restricted to only the backend side. Let we assume the compiler frontend, which is organized, is in following figure. So in the following figure, parser, static checker, and intermediate code generator. So these three phases generates intermediate code, and it comes along a sequencing. Sometimes they can be combined and folded into parsing. So the basic idea behind this front end is generates the intermediate code, and that intermediate code will be the input for the code generator, and that code generator generates our target code. So in the process of translating a program in a given source language into code for a given target machine, a compiler may construct sequence of intermediate representation as in a given figure. So the generation of the target code, there is one translating process. In that, the translating process, intermediate representation is one kind of a phase here. So in the intermediate representation also consists majorly to levels. We call it the high level intermediate representation, and second is low level intermediate representation. So high level representation are close to the source language, and low level representation are close to the target machine. So low level representation is suitable for a machine dependent task like register allocation and instruction selection. So for that purpose, we have to take one kind of representation that will be three address code. And that three address code is a range from high to low level, and it depending on the choice of the operator set. So let me discuss about the three address code and its transfer. So first we discuss some representation which is required for the three address code, and that is nothing but the DAG. DAG is nothing but direct acyclic graphs. So graph is nothing but consists nodes as well as the edges. So like the syntax tree for an expression, a DAG has a leaves corresponding to atomic operands and interior nodes corresponding to operators. Means in the DAG, leaves means child nodes corresponds to operands, and interior nodes and the root nodes correspond to the operators here. So difference between syntax tree and the DAG is likewise, in the DAG, nodes having more than one parent for each and every sub expression. Means that there is one common sub expression there. For the common sub expression having more than one parent, but it is not impossible in syntax tree. So DAG not only represent expressions, but also it describes some rules, and by that rules, by using the rules, intermediate representation will be generated here. So what is the DAG? So let me take one example. So given figure shows us the DAG for the expression like a plus a star into bracket b minus c bracket complete plus bracket b minus c bracket complete star d. So the leaf for a has a two parents, s, and one thing is that the leaves are nothing but the operand, and all other nodes is nothing but the operator. So the leaf for A has the two parents because A appears twice in the expression. So the two occurrences of sub expression B minus C are represented by a single node is nothing but minus. That node also has the two parents representing its two uses for the sub expression A star B minus C and B minus C star D. Even though B and C appears twice in the complete expression, their nodes each have one parent since both uses are the common sub expression B minus C. So this is DAG for the given expressions. In that the DAG, each and every child node is nothing but the operands, and all other remaining nodes is nothing but operators. So now we discuss about our familiar three address code use with three address code representation for generation of DAG. In three address code, there is at most one operator on the right hand side of an instruction. So the source language expression like x plus y star z might be translated into the sequence of three address instruction. Likewise, first we have to evaluate y star z operator. So that for y star j, we have to store the result in t1, t1 nothing but the temporary names which is generated by the compiler. So that t1 we have to use for the further compilation purpose. The further we have to evaluate a plus means plus operator. So x plus t1. So for that the y star j we have to replace t1 here and just compute the result and we will be stored into t2. So this t1 and t2 are nothing but the temporary generator names. So take one example also. So this is our given three address DAG, and so for that DAG we are written here three address codes here. So first we have to evaluate b-c, that b-c. One more thing is that the right hand side part of that three address code is consists at least one operator. So this b-c compute and stores the result in t1. The t1 we have to use for remaining purpose, means here start t1, we have to store the result t2, t2, t1, t3. Likewise, this t1, t2, t3, t4, t5 we use for our further computation. That t1, t2, t3, t4, t5 is nothing but the temporary variables and the temporary names are generated by the compiler here. But remember one thing, that the right hand side part consists at least one operator here and left side consists only one operand. So these three address code build from two major concepts. First is called addresses and second is instructions. So let me discuss one first part is nothing but addresses. And addresses can be one of the following. First, name means we use name to the address. So for convenience, we allow source program names to appear as address in the three address code. Means we use the source program name to the names also for the address. Secondly, constant values also we have to give for the addresses. Compiler generated temporary names, likewise our t1, t2, t3 we also use for the given name for the addresses. Second, instruction. Here is the list of common three address instruction forms. Assigning the instructions of the form x is equals to y opz, where here op is nothing but the binary arithmetic logical operation. Since previously we discussed that instruction, it comes under our assignments instructions part here. Secondly, assignments of the form x is equals to opy. So op is unary operation. For the unary operation, one operand is missing. So that's why this kind of instruction is also comes under our three address code format. Then copy instruction of the form x is equals to y, means x is assigned to the value of y. Likewise, we are using conditional jumps, unconditional jumps and etc. as part in three address code format. So next is a quadruple. So this quadruple editable has four fields which we call. First is op operator. Second, ARG1 means argument first, ARG2 means argument second, and the result is our last. So the OP field contains an internal code of the for the operator. For example, the three address instruction x is equals to y plus z is represented by placing plus in operator format. Y is an argument first, z is an argument second, and x should be the result part. So how we convert or how we translate the given three address code to quadruple format. So let me take one example. So there is our three address code format, and that three address code format we just convert into quadruple tables here. So quadruple consists of four columns. First column should be for operator, second argument first, third argument second, and last will be the result part here. So let me take one example. T1 is equals to minus C is our first instruction in three address code. We have to convert that instructions into quadruple likewise. So minus should be an operator field. Argument 1 is C. Here is our missing of the argument. Second argument, then we have to keep it as blank. And result we have to store in T1, means we have to write here T1. So second instruction T2 is equal to B star T1. So star is our operator. B is our first argument, T1 is a second argument, and T2 is a result. So likewise, we have to keep all the information in quadruple format as operator, argument, argument, and the result. This is one kind of a representation of intermediate form. So next kind of is nothing but the triple. In the triple, we have to just eliminate the result column from our quadruple. We got triple. So triple has only three fields, which will which we call operator argument and argument 2. Note that the result field is used primarily for temporary names. So using triples, we refer to the result of operation XOPY by its position rather than by an explicit temporary names. In quadruple, we represent results in form of the temporary names, but in triple, we have to take the result in form of the positions here. Thus, instead of the temporary T1, a triple representation would refer to position like a 0, 1, 2, 3. Parenthesis numbers represent pointers into the triple structure itself. So how it is possible? So this is our syntax tree and this is its triples. So this minus is our operator and its argument is C here, second argument of C. So second star, this star be the operator, argument B, and this minus C is instruction already evaluated and the result is stored into the 0th position. So that 0th position we have to take for our argument 2 here. Likewise, 2th positions we have to store the result and that 2th positions we have to use for argument second. Means the result we have to store in the position format and that position format we have to use for the further evaluation. So it is nothing but the triple. Last kind of address code is static symbol assignment form. It is an intermediate representation that facilitates certain code optimization. All assignment in SSA are to variables with distinct names, hence the term static symbol assignment. Figure shows the same intermediate programming thread address code in a static symbol assignment form. Means we have to assign variable and it is statically, means what now? So consider this is a thread address code. So A plus B, after the calculation we have to store the result in P. So this P we have to give the name as P1. Here is a second kind of thread address code instruction is P minus C Q. Now this P in a static symbol assignment we have to take from this P1 for our further discussion. Likewise, Q in our thread address code we have to take as Q1 for our further discussion. Likewise, we have to go ahead. So this is second time P occurs for that P2. This is third P3. Likewise, we have to represent this static symbol assignment form by using our thread address code for our intermediate representation part. Thank you so much.